We do indeed have the surprise. I had a feeling that it might be her, but it is in fact the beautiful Xongile. I wasn't quite sure. Nobody had let me know exactly which leopard it was, but it's lovely to see her, found by Tax and Aubrey. She's back once again to her old haunt at Treehouse Dam. And I'm sure this happens all the time. I'm sure that leopard cubs get separated from their mom on a relatively regular basis at this age. But for us, because we know them so well, it's actually really quite heartbreaking to witness. She looks so very lost and alone. And she's desperately searching for her mom. For those of you, perhaps for whom this is a first-time viewing experience, this is Xongile. And she's only 14 months old. And it's been, from what I've heard, I've been on leave, of course, but from what I understand, it's been at least 2 weeks since she was last with her mum, which is really very distressing for such a young leopard. And yesterday when I saw her, she was walking all of the sort of favourite routes that her mum would take them along, all the sort of places where we've seen them regularly in the past, obviously desperately searching for the rest of her family, her brother and her mother. We don't have any idea where they are, but it's good to see that Xongile is alive and well and back at Treehouse Dam. And if she stays here, if she stays in these places, it's going to be a lot easier for her mother to find her. Shame. Poor little girl. It's all very confusing at the moment. I'm just going to shuffle around a little bit. We'll spend our last few minutes of the sunset safari with her, but I just want to try and get us a slightly different view. Nice and slowly. Those of you who've watched Xongile grow up, you know just how comfortable she is with our vehicles. And she's still comfortable with them, but it's not quite the same as it used to be with her. It's not that she's lost confidence in us. It's that she's lost confidence in herself. She's so nervous. I noticed it yesterday, her body language when she comes up to us. Let me move out of your way so that you can see her. Her body language when she walked past us was not the same bold, cocky Xongile that we've always known. It was slinky and nervous. And I don't want to push her or make her feel uncomfortable in any way. She's had a little bit of a knock in her life. She's done so well up until now. Mom's looked after her so well, and Karula will continue to do so. But it probably regularly happens that they lose each other. Hey, girl. But you can imagine the stress she's going through, searching constantly, and she's hungry as well. She needs a good snack. Hopefully she managed to catch some scrub hares from when we saw her yesterday. So after all that, even though she'd crossed to the south, she must have popped back again, which means that she's been moving pretty much all day, which is exhausting for a young leopard. Are you going to catch some terrapins, like Vutomi did when he was alone? It's not a bad survival technique, little girl. If you can catch one, might not be the tastiest snack in the world, but it is a snack. She is looking at something down there. Oh, now she's looking at us. Hi, little one. I'm just gonna sit for a moment in silence and let you enjoy the sounds of the bush as well. It's the perfect time to listen to bird calls. The most beautiful time of day with one of the most beautiful creatures. Now, Omkar, you want to know whether or not I think that there's a possibility that Karula's just making space for Xongile. since female leopards do give, or at least their offspring end up establishing territories using part of their mother's territories. It's a good question, and if Xongile were a little bit older, I would say that yes, there would be a possibility of that. She spotted something just by the way. She's looking down at something in the bushes. So I think it's a possibility, it would be a possibility if she were older, but it's not really how leopards work, and she's just too young for that to be what's happening here. I think they just got lost. I think that there's quite possible that Karula went off mating, because she hasn't been seen in a while. And that's the best possible explanation, because Karula's not really a mysterious... she is a mysterious leopard, but she doesn't disappear for extended periods. Look, she's slinking, she's hunting something. She's after something. I can't reposition now, we're just going to have to wait and see. Come on, girl. Come on, girl. Oh, it must be a terrapin she's after. Okay, I think we can... Oh, no, she's got it. There she goes. She is self-sufficient, and it was a terrapin. Well done, girl. Very well done. Shame. Well done, little Xongile. She's done just as Vutomi did. And she's surviving on the creatures that she can catch. And all that time practicing and playing and hunting terrapins has paid off. Let's reposition quickly so we can watch her eat it. Chris, you say, is it not time for her to be by herself? No, not just yet. She's a little bit too young. She's only 14 months old. She'd only really start to be showing signs of independence at around about, I would say, 18 months, possibly even closer to 2 years, but around about 18 months, she'd start to be off on her own. 14 months, I mean, if you look at Xongile, she's tiny. She's not yet ready. She's not yet equipped enough to be off on her own. It's just that little bit too early. However, you raise a good point in that the older she gets, the more signs of independence she's going to start showing. And she might actually have moved, away of her own accord and then just found herself in a situation where she couldn't find mum again, which would be very confusing and quite scary. Hi, guys. Oh, there you go. She's caught herself a terrapin, and now comes the very tricky process of trying to figure out exactly how to get in that. Oh, yuck. Not very nice, is it, Xongile? But it will do. And doesn't that make you feel just that little bit happier about the situation? Knowing that she is managing to catch things like this, and as difficult as they are to get into and as smelly as they are to eat, it will sustain her until Karula finds her once again. Copy. Thanks very much, guys. Are you guys okay there? Now, Bobby, you want to know if she actually broke that shell open. She hasn't managed to yet, and she probably will only be able to crack the outside edges, judging by the size of that terrapin. Obviously, the larger they are, the harder the shell is, the thicker the shell. So she might not be able to get right in there, but you can see she's already lifted up some of the outside scales on the edge, and now she's tucking in, trying to get in around the legs and around the head. And it's very similar to what we've seen Vutomi do in the past. She'll go in via the legs, or the hole where the head is, and essentially break apart those slightly thinner bits of bone, and she'll be able to get to the meat inside. But she won't be able, that's quite a big terrapin. She's not going to be able to crack open that massive shell, unless by some sheer fluke she drops it from her height, which I don't think she'd have the problem-solving abilities to do that. Oh, shame, look at her licking it. She's so hungry. I can't wait to see them reunited once again. I'm sure it's going to happen. It's just a matter of time and a matter of them finding each other. But just imagine the joyous moment when we see all of them together again. And as I said, it probably happens to all leopards of this age. They get a little bit too brave and a little bit too bold. Alcida, you want to know if she manages to break the shell open, will she eat it? Yes, she will. She absolutely will. Now, terrapins might not be the most appetizing thing on her menu. In fact, I'm sure she'd prefer that it was a tortoise, because they are much less smelly. Oh, sorry, you were wondering if she'd eat the actual shell. She might chew on it. She might chew on it. Sorry, Bobby. She might chew on it, but I don't know that she wouldn't eat it fully. It would be much too hard for her to chew through, and I don't think it would be worth the effort she'd have to put into it. But you can see, she hasn't quite managed that yet. The other problem... Oh, she's heard something. At least she's alert. Making sure that nothing's going to sneak up on her. That's a very good life skill to have. And she'll be much less at risk of things like hyenas. I can hear something as well. Sorry, I'm just going to sit for a second and listen. I think it was just a bird fluttering somewhere. No, whatever it was, she's not concerned. And she can hear things much better than I can. So back to tucking in to her terrapin. It's going to be very difficult for her to break into that one. It's a very large terrapin. That is a terrapin that is not having a very good day at all. Okay, let me just shift a bit closer so that the people behind me can see. I'm just going to turn on. Hold on a second. We're switching to infrared. Oh, she abandoned it. Is she going to go and try for a smaller one? Hello, girl. Hey, pretty girl. You can see she's not nervous of us. Just a change in her body language. Hello, little one. Are you going to try again? Try and get a smaller one. And let's shift back to normal. I'm actually going to get my spotlight on now. And just ever so gently illuminate the site a little bit. I don't want to sabotage any of her hunting attempts, so I don't really want to shine anywhere near the water or anything like that. We'll just have to make do with this light for now. And there she goes back towards the water's edge. And now she's going to play the patience game. Oh, all those terrapin heads popping out, girl. I can see at least 10, but they're all in the middle of the dam. Might have to try going around the other side. She's glancing across. She's got to try and find one that's slightly smaller than the one she caught earlier. She spotted one. she's got to wait patiently for it to come a bit closer. Luckily, her mom's taught her about patience very, very well. Come on. Those monkeys are still alarm calling. That's what she was listening to. Charles, if you stand by for 1 second, I'll move forward a bit. I'm just going to go forward a little bit, guys. Oh, we have a question. Sorry, I didn't quite hear who it was from, but a question about how long a leopard can survive without food. Retty, you wanted to know how long can a leopard survive without food. And the answer is, it depends on how big the leopard is, really. It's a difficult question to answer, absolutely. You're probably looking at around about 3 or so weeks. And, of course, Xongile has not been without food completely. She has been catching things like scrub hares and terrapins. So probably around about 3 weeks for a big leopard, probably even longer. How long can a human being go without food? Again, it depends on the human being. But for them, the problem is, of course, once they get to that point where they haven't eaten for an extended period of time, then they get weaker and weaker. And what that means is that they will then start to struggle to eat and struggle to feed. And struggle to hunt, at least. It becomes harder and harder for them. So even though they can survive for an extended period of time, they need to be able to eat regularly in order to be able to continue to hunt. Xongile is thin, but she's definitely nowhere near at the point of starvation. She's going to be fine. Oh, little girl, looking at us beseechingly. I don't know where your mom is, my girl. I'm sorry. And we saw that she was unable to get into that large terrapin, so now she's searching for a small one. And Mia, you want to know if a leopard would ever learn to drop a terrapin from a height in order to break it open? Probably not. It's unlikely. They generally don't have the best problem-solving skills in terms of the various mammals out here. That title belongs to something like a spotted hyena. That is a very, very good problem solver. I don't think a leopard would learn that it would have to drop a terrapin from up high. But different leopards become specialized in hunting different things. So never say never. Leopards have a way of surprising us and doing the most unexpected things. Especially when it comes to survival. I'm still reluctant. I'm reluctant to spotlight her just because I think that the glare off the water might actually hinder her trying to hunt terrapins. Go around the other side, girl. There's lots of them coming out. Lots and lots. I suppose this is a good spot in terms of cover. Stopping to have a drink. Now, Kristen, you want to know if she'd found Karula with another male. Would Karula chase her away? No, Karula wouldn't, but there's a good chance that the male would. And that's just because males tend to become very protective over a female in estrus. Again, leopards don't read textbooks and sometimes they do very unexpected things. So, I mean, I could tell you that and then the next thing you hear of somebody seeing a mating pair and a cub feeding and sharing a kill or something like that. But chances are it would be the male that would chase the cub away, so as not to interrupt his mating prospects. Especially, of course, if it wasn't his cub. If it was not Xongile's potential father, he could end up killing her if she were to approach a mating pair. Karula might try to protect her, but there's only so much Karula would be able to do against the strength of a male. What's in there, girl? What you got? She's exploring something in there. Could be a terrapin that's come out. She's found something in there. I can hear her scrabbling about. What have you got? I don't know what she's trying to get out. I don't know if she's found something hiding underneath a branch there, but she's desperately scrabbling around underneath it. Unfortunately, this is probably going to be about as good a view as we get. Hopefully she brings whatever it is out for us. Where on earth? It looks like a bit of buffalo hip bone. What is that, girl? I'm just gonna go forward a little bit. She's found a piece of rotten carcass. It looked like it might have been a scapula or a piece of hip bone or something like that. Maybe from one of the buffalo drought deaths. It stinks. Oh, Xongile. Poof. I can't see her. It is so tricky in there. She's just through here. Yeah, she's pulled out a bit of carrion, but a very old, perhaps hidden there by a hyena, a hip bone or something like that. That's what she's got. I can't see exactly what it is. Sorry, I'm just trying to see exactly what this leopard's doing, but there's no view of her. We absolutely can't see her. There's nowhere I can go, really, to position so that we can see her. Let me try. I'll go backwards. Maybe backwards will work. Not really. No, there's nowhere I can go to get a view of her. She's completely invisible here. Sorry. I'll try turning round, but I don't think that's gonna work so well. Reese, absolutely, that is something that she would do. She absolutely would raid a bird nest for food. That would be on her, absolutely would be on her agenda. Let's see if maybe we can see her here. Or she just walked into the road. There she is. I'm just showing the guys where she is. Sorry, everybody. I'm just trying to help everybody out here. without shining directly in their faces. There we go. Okay, we better keep the spotlight on then. There we go. Just a faint glimmer of spots. So we're just playing around. Sorry, everybody. We've just been playing around with the infrared to try and see exactly how it works. Now, Sad, do you want to know whether or not she sleeps in trees at night in order to... Thad. Thad, not Sad. I was going to say, Sad's quite a sad name. Thad. You want to know if she's sleeping in trees to protect herself at night. She might be. She might also be. I mean, bear in mind, of course, that leopards are entirely at home in the darkness. So she might also be wandering about in the darkness as well. But there's a chance she's sleeping in trees. She might also, because she's so tiny, she is very, very, she can be very, very well hidden by just crawling underneath a tree or a bush. Something thick, something like a bush willow, for example. Sorry, the spotlight seems to be having troubles. Something like a tree or a very dense bush, she might hide underneath there and sleep there. And I mean, we've had sightings, look at her now, in just a patch of grass. We've had sightings with Xongile where she's basically vanished. And she's been less than a few feet from us. So a leopard's camouflage is truly exceptional. I have absolutely no idea how she managed to find that piece of carcass. She obviously smelt it, or perhaps knew it was there in the past, but never had to bother with it before. But Orjan, she could pretty much eat it no matter how old it is. You wanted to know how old it must be before it would be dangerous for her to eat. But a leopard's digestive system is so resilient, and their bodies are so resilient and accustomed to eating rotten meat, that generally speaking, they're pretty much immune to almost any kind of upset stomach. They'll get an upset stomach, but it won't be a sort of a really dangerous gastroenteritis kind of infection. They might just feel a little bit ill, a little bit nauseous. So it doesn't actually matter how old it is. And leopards scavenge far more frequently than we realize. It happens on a regular basis. We saw it with Futomi as well. With Futomi scavenging, there's her pretty face. With Futomi scavenging off that old, old buffalo carcass. Oh, we've got some tricky shuffling around to do and some chatting with the other vehicles. So while we do that, let's go and see what Byron has planned for the evening's darkness.